The Premier is facing renewed pressure to establish an anti-corruption body, this time from within the union movement. And some of the most powerful unions are also planning to use this weekend's Labor Party conference to target the government's controversial work cover changes.
The Premier and his deputy looked in control at the bridge of HMAS Parramatta as it docked for the official opening of the new Tech Court wharf at Outer Harbour. Mike Rann will be hoping to continue the smooth sailing this weekend as the Labor Party finalises its election platform at the Festival Centre. Last year, the government's cuts to WorkCover compensation incensed the ALP's industrial base.
The great thing about Labor Party conferences is there's always a bit of controversy.
But when elections are close, it always pays to smooth the waters. Today, three of the most powerful unions met staff of the Industrial Relations Minister to discuss a raft of motions aimed at softening the WorkCover laws.
There's a lot of other unions who've got same concerns in regards to the WorkCover amendments, and we'll address them and hopefully sit down with the Minister and look at those issues and raise issues in regards to the concern of our members.
Mike Rann is adamant his stance on WorkCover was the right one.
I'm the Premier of a state for all of the people in the state, not just for those who are members of the Labor Party and not just for those who elected us.
Regardless, a key union is also pushing another uncomfortable point for the Premier. The AMWU has a motion to set up an anti-corruption watchdog, despite Mr Rann's insistence that a state-based body is a waste of money. The party denies it's a slap in the face.
I wouldn't say so. I mean, look, the Labor Party is a broad church, very open. If branches want to put forward motions, they put forward motions.
And this motion, which echoes a key platform of the Liberals, is unlikely to win the support of the Labor majority. Nick Harmson, ABC News, Adelaide.